So next we are going to see another conic hyperbola, okay, which is similar to ellipse. It will differ from the ellipse in two, three aspects only. The first aspect is the equation differs each other. In ellipse you are having plus, but whereas in the case of hyperbola you are having minus. And the second major change is the diagram. So for the ellipse you are having diagram different, and for the hyperbola you are having another diagram. So these are all the two major differences between hyperbola and the ellipse. Other than that, all the formulas for type 1 of ellipse, type 1 of hyperbola are same. Formulas are same, except one or two formulas. I will mention the formulas which are different each other. Okay. So other than that, what we are having, the template and formulas are same. That is center, foci, vertices, directrices are same for type 1 of ellipse and type 1 of hyperbola, for the type 2 of ellipse and the type 2 of hyperbola. Okay. So you have to remember the equation diagram which are going to be the different. Okay. Similar in the case of ellipse, you are having two types of hyperbola and also two equations. In standard form means the center is 0, 0. Non-standard form means the center is h, k. These are all the two differences. And we can classify the ellipse with the major and the minor axis. But here you should not use major and minor axis, but you should use the term transverse axis, conjugate axis. There you are telling major axis, minor axis, but in the hyperbola you have to tell it as transverse axis and the conjugate axis, but the concept is the same. Okay. Now the equation for type 1, x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1. Okay. So now this is for type 1 non-standard with vectors h, k. Here you have to write the transverse axis parallel to x axis and the conjugate axis parallel to y axis. Okay. Here the equation is x minus h the whole square by a square minus y minus k the whole square by b square equal to 1. In the ellipse, additionally you will have the condition a is greater than b. But in the hyperbola, there is no such a condition. Either a greater than b or b greater than a, whatever may be the thing. Idhila a liyum b liyum periya number chinna number indra variation nama paaka maatom. Ana ellipse la periya number eduvo adhukku mela irukkiradha nama major axis nu edukkom. Ana hyperbola porathalavula andha maari nama eduka maatom. There is no such a difference between a and b. The first number should be taken as a square, whether it may be a greater or smaller. அது என்ன நம்பர் ஆகணும் அது a square னு எடுத்துக்கணும். அதே மாதிரி first இருக்கிறது தான் நமக்கு transverse axis. Positive ல x இருந்துச்சுன்னா x transverse axis. Here the positive is y, so y transverse axis. Okay. And the type 2. Type 2 transverse axis is y axis and the conjugate axis is x axis. Here the equation is y square by a square minus x square by b square equal to 1. Transverse axis x axis, x will be in the first positive, and transverse axis y axis, y will be in the positive. Whereas in the case of non-standard type, the transverse axis is parallel to y axis and the conjugate axis is parallel to x axis, whose equation is y minus k the whole square by a square minus x minus h the whole square by b square equal to 1. So now we are going to write the formulas, diagram for each and every type individually.